Hello guys, welcome back to Watch Time! Today's movie recap will be a comedy and sci-fi movie from 2005 called The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Warning, there are spoilers ahead. The film begins with a young man, Arthur Dent. On a Thursday morning, as he awakens, he notices that the items around him are shaking on their own. This unusual movement is due to construction workers who plan to tear down his home to make way for a highway. Arthur, unwilling to let his home be destroyed, attempts to block the workers by lying down in front of them. Shortly thereafter, his friend, Ford, arrives at his residence. Arthur informs Ford that his home is on the verge of being demolished by the construction crew. Ford mentions that there is an issue of greater significance than the impending demolition of Arthur's house. He shares all the beer he brought with the construction crew. After they enjoy the beer, they head to a nearby bar. In the bar, Ford discloses that he is not an Earthling, but originates from a distant galaxy. He warns that Earth is going to be destroyed soon. Arthur is skeptical of everything Ford is saying. To persuade him, Ford recalls their initial encounter when he first arrived on Earth and mistakenly tried to shake hands with a car. Observing this weird act, Arthur quickly intervened, saving Ford and informing him that the car was not a robot with which he could make acquaintances. As a result, he feels a strong sense of obligation to Arthur for rescuing him. He intends to repay this act of kindness by helping Arthur escape from Earth, which is no longer a safe place. Subsequently, Arthur shares stories about his romantic partner, Trillian. They first connected at a social gathering and gradually grew closer. At one such event, a man named Zaphod interrupts the party, claiming to be from another planet. With time pressing, Ford urges Arthur to depart from the bar. Upon their return to Arthur's residence, they discover it being razed to the ground. Soon after, an enormous and unfamiliar spaceship looms overhead, causing widespread panic due to the extraterrestrial activity. As the spaceship descends into the atmosphere, Ford swiftly takes Arthur and conceals him inside another spacecraft. As anticipated, this spacecraft can easily obliterate the Earth. Once inside, Ford informs Arthur that they are aboard a ship belonging to the Vogons. The Vogons are among the most peculiar alien species. They aren't inherently malicious, but are quick to react and prone to meddle in affairs. Acting on commands from their higher-ups, they efficiently address issues, much like space patrol officers. They respond and act strictly based on instructions from their leaders. During this time, Ford places an unusual device into Arthur's ear, which serves to translate every language in the universe. Shortly thereafter, a Vogon discovers them on board and promptly detains them. They are ejected into outer space, but they encounter another spacecraft that takes them in. Inside, Ford is surprised to find Zaphod, who is revealed to be his cousin. Zaphod has also recently been elected as the president of the entire galaxy, having won over a competitor named Kavala in the election. Additionally, Zaphod possesses two faces, each with its distinct personality. Arthur experiences a shock when he encounters Trillian again. It appears that she was taken into outer space after her earlier meeting with Zaphod at the party. Meanwhile, amidst Zaphod's presidential inauguration, he unexpectedly commandeers a highly sophisticated spaceship. Following his theft, the vice president, Questular, collaborates with the Vogons to apprehend him. He intentionally took the ship to explore the mysteries of a planet known as Magrathia. He presents ancient records that reveal, millions of years ago, a civilization engaged in intense discussions about life and the cosmos. Additionally, there was a supercomputer known as Deep Thought, capable of answering any questions posed to it. Two young individuals resembling the leaders of Magrathia visited to consult it. They sought insights into the life of the universe, but were instructed to wait 7.5 million years for the responses. To summarize, after 7.5 million years, the two children returned to confront Deep Thought. By this time, Magrathia has become populated, and the locals are excited about the event. Since the children had initially requested a straightforward answer, Deep Thought responds with simply 42. This immediately confuses everyone who hears it. The problem lies in the vagueness of the questions posed by the children. They inquired broadly about life and the universe without providing specific details. Thus, the cryptic reply, 42, continues to be an unresolved mystery to this day. Upon listening to the recording, Zaphod decides to travel to Magrathia to seek direct answers about the cosmos from Deep Thought. As they set course for the planet, they inadvertently end up on Viltvatel 6, which is under the leadership of Kavala. Upon arrival, Zaphod inquires about the precise location of Magrathia. Kavala agrees to provide the coordinates, but only if Zaphod retrieves a particular weapon from the planet for him. To ensure compliance, Kavala promptly severs one of Zaphod's heads. As they prepare to depart from Viltvatel 6, a contingent of Vogons arrives, intent on returning the president to his home planet. The Vogons suspect that Arthur and his companions have abducted Zaphod. In an unfortunate turn of events, Trillian is captured by a Vogon and taken to their home planet. The rest of the group swiftly devises a plan to rescue her. They use a mini spaceship and set off for the Vogon planet immediately. Upon her arrival, Trillian is confronted with the revelation from the Vogon that Earth has been obliterated by their actions, following orders from none other than President Zaphod himself. This was unexpected, as she did not foresee Zaphod having the intention to destroy Earth. Accused of abducting the president, Trillian is sentenced to be executed by being drowned alive. Meanwhile, they instruct a robot called Marvin to head back to the spaceship while the rest of the group proceeds to rescue Trillian. They start by creating a release document for Trillian, purportedly under presidential orders. Once the form is submitted, the Vogon quickly frees her. He and Questular come to understand that Trillian and her companions are not evil. They had not intended to kidnap Zaphod, and the situation was merely a miscommunication among them all. After her release from captivity, Trillian feels profound anger towards Zaphod for his role in the destruction of Earth. Immediately after, they depart from the location. To keep tabs on Zaphod's movements, Questular and the Vogons decide to pursue them. Eventually, they all converge on Magrathia. Ford, Zaphod, and Trillian successfully make their way into the portal to Deep Thought, while Arthur and Marvin are unable to enter and are left to wait outside. As they endure a lengthy wait, a man named Slar, who specializes in planet construction, approaches them. He offers Arthur a chance to view the planet he has created. Meanwhile, the others reach Deep Thought and pose their questions about the universe, but regrettably, they receive no answers at all. Since they don't receive the answer they were seeking, they shift their focus to locating the weapon that Kavala had previously requested. This weapon is uniquely designed to force anyone it targets to either speak or experience pain. Upon acquiring the weapon, Trillian intentionally uses it on Zaphod to uncover why he orchestrated the destruction of Earth. It emerges that the annihilation was the result of a miscommunication between him and the Vogons. Zaphod reassures them by revealing that he has prepared a second version of Earth, which will soon be ready. Subsequently, they teleport to another location. Returning to Arthur and Slar, they are on a train journey to view Slar's project. Slar shares that he is constructing a second version of Earth, which will soon be completed. During their tour of this new Earth, they observe space workers engaged in tasks like filling oceans, crafting mountains, and other activities. Slar has also constructed a new house for Arthur. When Arthur enters this house, he finds his friends already there, enjoying a meal. As they engage in conversation, the situation changes when Questular and the Vogons appear outside Arthur's house and begin shooting. The group quickly seeks refuge in a caravan, during which Marvin unfortunately receives a blow to the head. Soon after regaining consciousness, Marvin retrieves the weapon he had acquired in Magrathia. He uses it to fire a shot, which causes the group of Vogons to collapse instantaneously. The Vogons are then transported back to their planet via a spaceship, while Zaphod and Questular have a reunion. Ultimately, they choose to visit a restaurant at the edge of the universe. Meanwhile, Slar and his team continue working on completing the new version of Earth, making sure to include plants, animals, and humans to resemble the original Earth. Thanks for watching! Don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe. Take care, and see you next time!